much. If your cell phone plan isn't spooky enough for you, this Halloween we know of one place that will really scare you.
Yeah, in the spirit of the holiday, Veronica White went inside a home that is reportedly haunted.
Kerner's Folly, you probably heard about it. It's been investigated multiple times for paranormal activity. Well, little Veronica spent the night there with our photographer,
Veronica.
Katie Gore, and here's a look inside of Kerner's Folly.
The strangest house in the world. That's Kerner's Folly's nickname, and it's easy to see why. Well-known interior decorator and designer Jewel Gilmer Kerner built the quirky house with its elaborate decor and winding staircases in 1878 as a home for him, his wife, and their two children, and as a display of his work.
And he really used this house as his catalog. Every fireplace in the house is different, every doorway, every window, so his clients could come through and pick out what elements they wanted for their own homes.
But in addition to being a beautiful historical house in Kernersville, it's also featured in books and online as a place to have an otherworldly experience.
We investigated in June 2009, and I saw a woman standing on the stage upstairs in period clothing, bent over one of the chairs, and she disappeared in front of my eyes.
It's already been investigated by several teams of paranormal experts, including SPARS, better known as TAPS, made famous by the sci-fi channel's Ghost Hunters. Both this and the local groups have declared the old home haunted, and the home's new director, Dale, isn't surprised, but says the Ghost Hunters report the spirits as friendly and harmless.
I've heard rumors about laughter and giggling, just kind of this fun family atmosphere in the children's playrooms. The theater, there's also rumors up in Cupid's Park. I've never really heard anything concrete, but there's just kind of rumors of activity up there.
After Mr. Kerner and his wife passed away, the home was vacant for years, was then rented out to businesses in the 70s, and it opened to the public in the 90s. Now it turns many ghost skeptics into believers, who sometimes suggest that the builder is still showing off this masterpiece of a home. I'm Veronica White, WXII 12 News.